city, Vegas, lies in the other direction with the rest of its slaves. Or is it just you, courier, without the lights and ghosts? You are too late. The divide is awakening. The package and the message within have come full circle. The sequence has begun just as before. Except this time, the missiles will touch the sky instead of being locked beneath the ground. You've answered your own question, and you'll die with that question on your lips. You don't see, listen, even when it's all around you. No matter if I nailed it into your head like a gift from Caesar. You brought the divide to life, courier. You walked the road, brought the bear, then the bull, brought me, following your tracks. And when I saw the divide you made, I saw a second chance, a new way of thinking. My world, no longer the East. And you brought the West in that package. Destroyed it all. Nearly killed me, flesh and spirit. You destroyed something larger than the bear, greater than the bull. And even when you could have turned away, you brought it again in that machine. You destroyed a nation taking its first breath. A place that could have been my home. Now, I'll destroy yours. Not if you believe in what you follow. Kill no courier. Kaiser's words. I honored them. Other couriers could have been legion, like me. The truth is, you serve nothing, believe nothing, killing you meaningless. No, now there is purpose. I believe you when you say you were careless. The divide, the chip, the machine you brought here. Many messages can be taken from that, intended or not. What I do now is an act of conviction. Blame you? No. Learned from you. Both the weapon to kill a nation and the strength to do it. You showed me a road, a way to carry my message. You've already answered for what you've done. Now the flag you follow will answer for it. No, not the Mojave. The West. All that's been built since America died. Same symbols as before the war. Now a flag carried by a tribe of children. You walked the West, didn't stay. You know the reason. The bear grows without structure, follows a symbol without knowing its history. Without NCR to support it, Vegas will fall to the Legion. That grave of lights back to dust and ghosts, as was meant. After this, only one flag will remain over the Mojave. Let that one fly, or destroy itself. No need to destroy the bear, just cut its throat. You taught me that at the divide. Only need to cut off the supply line, the road, to watch something greater die. I'll turn the long 15 into miles of fire. Cut off the Mojave, NCR will fall back, lose Hoover Dam, and leave their throats exposed to the Legion. serve Vegas ghosts, not the tribes Vegas devoured. House is not the people of Vegas. You have walked the strip, yet have seen nothing. Your carelessness for the paths you walk, it has destroyed the city you serve. NCR will burn, then the walls of Vegas will follow. Yes, that is what you proved to me at the Divide. What is here, what you showed me, it is enough. You don't understand. You will. I'll finish history's work. If the Divide couldn't kill you, perhaps the spears of the old world can. Let's end this, Courier. You and I, here with the old world flag as witness. movement.
Come all this
divide erupted in fire as the flame trail of the two couriers' last message arced into the sky. Missiles fell on the east, and the Legion encampment at Drywells, where the Twisted Hears had allied, then been betrayed by Wulpus and Kaisar. Legion soldiers died, their silhouettes blasted into the ground and earth. The last word of the last of the Twisted Hears. It was an ending to things. A way of erasing the road that had led to this point and the history that had walked with it. At the end of the struggle, only one courier remained in the heart of the divide. The true courier. Courier 6. The courier tore the ancient flag of the Commonwealth from its cables and cast it over the corpse. Though whether done as a sign of respect or in anger for what had been endured to reach this moment, that is unknown. Interpretation is something best left to history, and only the surviving courier would ever know for certain. As for the courier, she turned her back on her home for the second time and made her way back, navigating the treachery of the divide. Tunnelers and the marked men avoided the lone figure, as if recognizing the courier's right to passage, or out of fear. The courier walked until she stood again upon the edge of the divide, the last road she would walk before the second battle for Hoover Dam. There, beside her feet, was a final package from one courier to another, a footlocker bearing a gift and a message. But that message, it is something for couriers to carry, and for them alone. The lights flickered across the divide, reminders that the old world histories persist and find meaning in the present. It said, war, war never changes. Women do, through the roads they walk. And this road has reached its end. Thank you.
Hey there. You looking to buy or sell? Can do. See ya.
here to jaw at me a while longer? Or are we ready to get this show on the road? Wait a minute, I recognize you. Yeah, you're Alice McLafferty's rising star, ain't you? You sure you want to be here? McLafferty's non-competes are pretty rigid. Just don't. It makes the new Canaanites powerful uncomfortable, and it scares the britches off the tribals. Don't talk about the burn man either while you're at it. Trust me on this one. It's for your own good. Are you now? You know we ain't coming back this way for a good long while now, right? And you know about the weight limit. I don't want no whining about old Mr. Masterson. I left my one-of-a-kind plasma cannon back at base. Can we go back for it? You sure you're ready now? All right. I reckon you know your limits. You keel over on me out there, though, and I'll leave your ass after we take everything useful you crammed in your pack. You sure about that this time? We ain't coming back for a while. Well, all right then. Let's get moving. We got a long road ahead of us. The paths we're following are slow going, so you might as well keep your ears open and listen to what old Jed has to say. A few decades back, folks in the NCR started to hear about a community in northern Utah called New Canaan. Didn't know much about them, except that they were religious folks, sent out missionaries to talk to the tribes. We've seen our share of cults, but the New Canaanites, they were honest traders. Good fighters, too. Raiders wouldn't tangle with them. But then, the Legion appeared in Arizona. I reckon you know all about them. Turns out Caesar's first war chief, the Malpace Legate, was a New Canaanite, Joshua Graham. Legend goes that Graham was the meanest, toughest son of a bitch in the whole damn Legion. The New Canaanites wouldn't talk about him. They were ashamed. Guess I can't blame them. Well, at Hoover Dam, the Malpace Legate finally met his match. Hanlon and Oliver kicked his New Canaanite butt right back over the river. Caesar had to make an example for the others to show them that even at the highest level, failure wouldn't be tolerated. He had Graham covered in pitch, lit on fire, and thrown into the Grand Canyon. People say he didn't even scream on the way down. Not long after, some of the slaves and tribals started to talk. Said Graham wasn't dead. Shouldn't have been any surprise. All this talk bothered Caesar, so he forbade anyone from speaking his name. Wanted to erase Joshua Graham from history. He got his wish. Joshua Graham disappeared, and in his place came legends of the burned man walking the wastes. Probably just a tribal ghost story. But New Canaan's been silent for a long time. Maybe it's a coincidence. Maybe the Malpace Legate is dead. Or maybe Joshua Graham did crawl out of that canyon and finally found his way back home. All right, people. Been a long couple of weeks. But here we are. Zion. I know your feet hurt. I know you're tired. But I need everyone's mind on the trail ahead.
Ain't the trail ahead worries me, Jed. Those descents we made through that slot canyon back up there. Ain't no way we're getting back out the way we come. And then what?
God damn it, Stella heard you the first time. And the 15th, too. The New Canaanites will know a way. And if they don't, we've got the maps on our friend's Pip-Boy over there. Enough lollygagging. Get moving. And keep an eye out for tribals.
Sorry to bother you with reality, old Jed. Who cares if we can't get back up the way we come? That's not a problem.
I condemn.
Oh,
so it was that the conflict between the New Canaanites and the White Legs was finally resolved. The courier's involvement had tipped the scale, shifting the fragile balance of power.
With Daniel dead, the White Legs soon overran Zion and drove the sorrows and dead horses from the valley. The White Legs plundered all of the pre-war buildings the Sorrows had marked off-limits. Their squalor an affront to Zion's natural beauty. By year's end, little trace remained that the Sorrows had ever made the valley their home.
Already weakened by several seasons of bad trading, the Happy Trails Caravan Company was devastated by the failure of its expedition. The New Canaanites never re-established ties with the caravan. Their experiences with outsiders near the Great Salt Lake and in Zion had been far too negative. Within 6 months, the Happy Trails Caravan Company was bankrupted and dissolved.
In the shadow of Daniel's death, those Sorrows who survived the assault on Zion Valley mourned his loss, as was their custom. Word of Daniel's passing reached the New Canaanites several weeks later. They prayed that their brother would be well received by their Lord.
And with that, the courier walked out of the history of the tribes of Zion and back to the gathering storm of the Mojave Wasteland.
You've heard of the Sierra Madre Casino. We all have. The legend, the curses, foolishness about it lying in the middle of the city of the dead, buried beneath a blood-red cloud. A bright, shining monument luring treasure hunters to their doom. The world's most famous stars and entertainers were invited to its grand opening. An invitation was a sign of exclusiveness. The opening was supposed to symbolize a road to a brighter future, not just for the world, but for all who came to its doors. A chance for anyone to begin again. Except, the Sierra Madre never opened. The war froze it in time, like a big flashbulb going off. The grand opening, one big ending of humanity. It's still out there, in the wastes, preserved, just waiting for someone to crack it open. But getting to it, that's not the hard part. It's letting go.
They had cut others off from. Too many, many. This place is dangerous. And its quarantine measures, its hazards, have claimed many failures upon failures. Do you think I wanted to place collars on you to ensure compliance? No. If robots could have done this, I would have sent them. The Sierra Madre is a complicated lock. Cracking it open requires human hands. The Sierra Madre has many defenses, means of screening guests for illicit or dangerous items. Your arrival here, weaponless, was not my intention. The casino, this villa, it takes anything with even a trace of radioactivity, traces of unknown substances, and returns it home, the bunker. The process is automated, and the casino itself has other similar services. I was unable to find a workaround except to send others in as tools. Still, I have not left you defenseless. And the Sierra Madre's security, in some respects, can help you if you are resourceful enough. This place is well preserved. Few who came here ever return. All the treasures of the old world lie scattered about, virtually untouched. Search, hunt, craft what you can from what you find. The trash of the pre-war era can keep you alive. Food, knives, more. Use them. Even those toxins and the residue it leaves behind can be shaped into tools and weapons, gatherers as well. Also, there is one more thing in your possession. A rifle that will keep you alive. As surely as the collar will. It is a hollow rifle, a weapon I constructed when I arrived. I have since made superior models and modifications. For now, that tool will have to do until you find other weapons. And I suggest you do. The hollow rifle's ammo is limited. Still, it should serve well enough. I fashioned it from the holograms of the villa and used it against the villa's living inhabitants. Yes, inhabitants. Avoid them if you can. They are difficult to kill. Whatever has created them, bullets, explosions, energy, it can make them inert for a time, then they seem to crawl back up, restored. Perhaps it's the clock. Perhaps something in their physiology. Blankets the sky here. You may smell it in the air. Copper and sulfur. Burns the lungs and seeps into the skin. As for its origins, I'm not certain. Pre-war industrial pollutants. Something in the Sierra Madre structure. It is unique across the wasteland. And deadly. It has kept this place preserved since the Great War. Leave alone if you into concentrated pockets of the cloud. Too long inside one, you'll die, so be careful where you step. I've seen some survive concentration of the cloud for short periods of time. If healthy enough, others were too weak. Rebreathers, chemical suits, there is no protection against it. It decays all it touches. I found fighting it useless. From the cloud, inside buildings, tunnels, any place not exposed to the outside air. Anything the cloud has touched has preserved it one way or another, but only the holograms in the villa truly remain. I've downed instructions and markers on your Pip-Boy, in case you forget. And yes, I have access to that device on your wrist. Get the other three here after that. I'll have more instructions for you. Do this, I'll let you go. I'll let all of you go. Mr. Rocco Trash will help you, I've insured him. He can latch onto the signal of the callers and tune into their frequencies. The bomb callers come with radios embedded in them. You can eavesdrop easily. It was part of their design to listen in. They can even screen out white noise from the environment to allow greater monitoring. Yes. Caller 8, the FEV reject, the super mutant. He's docile, predictable, and provided he's not starving, should be easy to command. I lost contact with him some time ago. Probably after he dragged you here from the trap. Find him. He'll follow you, caller or no. Good. If necessary, I will guide you through the village broadcast systems. If you get lost, return here and I'll direct you. I've downloaded instructions on an audio log to your Pip-Boy in case you can't read. If you forget why you're here, let my voice remind you.
Let your eyes take in the luxurious expanse of the open desert under clear, starlit skies. Gaze straight on into the sunset from our villa rooftops. Countless diversions await. Gamble in our casino, take in the theater, or stay in one of our exclusive executive suites that will shelter you and cater to your every whim. So if life's worries have weighed you down, if you need an escape from your troubles, or if you just need an opportunity to begin again, join us. Let go and leave the world behind us.
Thank you. effect, one I did not anticipate. I was unable to calibrate the colonists to block the signals. So, you'll have to make do.
Noise makes my stomach hurt.
Speak to the beast inside, then be good.
I promise, Master. Just keep him.
Dog, back in the cage.
What have we here? You weren't who I was expecting. I'm disappointed. Still, even if you aren't my intended guest, you take direction. Good. You can't have been an idiot to figure out how to release me from my cage. Or perhaps you are, with that leash on your arm and the one around your neck. With our collars and manacles, why, we may as well be kin. I'm the voice of reason. I sleep sometimes, down in the basement, in the cage. Now that I'm awake, Dog goes back in the cage. Dog knows I'm here, but can't do anything about it. I'm his conscience. Keep him tame, keep him from hurting us, doing foolish things. I've been trapped in here for some time. Then you come along and let me out. So, you opened my cage for a reason. Now, I want to know why. Trauma. Yes, in a manner of speaking. Do you see these wounds of his covering his skin? The bear trap on his arm. He placed his own hand in it. The name he carved in his chest. To remind him of who he is, he inflicts pain on himself to silence me when all I try to do... He cuts, hurts, and tries to murder me out of him. He won't succeed. Just makes me angrier. Dog is the beast. We simply change cages. Like the ones here. It's close. Closer than I'd like. Dog's been into things. Needs to think before he eats. Chew before he swallows. He's eager that way. Now the collar's a part of me. Inside. I can feel its electronic heartbeat clicking and burning down below. Like before. It was cold and heavy before going in the cage. Now you're here, and it's pulling and kicking again. Tugging like a leash. Interesting. They detach. When segmented, they look like nothing more than metallic rad scorpions. And if they're attached to neck flesh, warm, red. Dog doesn't care what's on the body he's crushing in his hands. He'll mangle it, twist it, make it fit until he's full. Dog can't help himself. Hungry, greedy. And now the collar's inside, alive again. And we're trapped here until it goes cold. Really? Yet it led you here, to me. And now you're here, and it's burning a hole in my guts. Maybe it's crying for its owner. As if I had a choice. Sometimes instinct takes over, and that's when I go into the cage. It's like curiosity that way. After all, you wouldn't have put that collar on by choice. Perhaps it was your curiosity that caused that hand to close on your neck.
No. No, I don't think so. Even in here, I have more control than you do. I'm not leaving until the one who controls the collars shows. Not his voice, not his hand, not his lackey. Him. And when he comes to see me, we'll settle things. So go on. Go back to your master. Tell him I'm waiting for him. Dog may follow him. I won't. Then I still win. I'd rather die in this cell than have Dog follow him any longer. Follow his orders, his commands, desperate for recognition. The old man, he has the need to hold on to the past, to the Madre. I'd rather be free, let go of this shell, than have it cage me any longer. No, I don't trust you. Even if you're not working with him, you'll fall into the same trap he did. You may think you can take your revenge. That'll change. You'll start thinking there's a way to have it all. Dog, you're not talking to him now, are you? No. Even if you could drag Dog out of his cage, you still couldn't get him out of this cage. I put him here for a reason. If he could have escaped, he would have. So here he stays. Of course you can't. This cage is locked tight. From you and the old man. The old man, the one who brought us here. I hid the key on me so Dog wouldn't know. I just need the old man to show up so he and I can talk. If Dog was in control when the old man appeared, well, he would just do whatever he commanded, as always. And I can't have that. Here when I arrived, so I made use of them, in a manner of speaking. More their voices, really. These collars, they don't just track us. You can eavesdrop on them as well. Tune to a frequency, and you can hear everything someone is saying. So perhaps it's a good thing that Dog swallowed his collar. Anyone listening would find it difficult to hear past the digestion. Why did I lock him in the cage? I locked him in because I could feel him getting hungry again. There wasn't much time. If Dog roams, he gets into trouble. Eats things he shouldn't. Listens to others he shouldn't. So he's safer in here. We're safer in here. I hoped if I locked him in here, the one he obeys would come for him. Instead, I get you. Of course you do. And so do I. Of course I know. Even if I don't see it happen. Down in the cage, I hear echoes of the footfalls, the click of the collars. Every time I see one of you, I know exactly how you got here. You couldn't help yourselves any more than dog can help himself. You heard the voice, the promise, and then you walked right into one of the old man's traps. Then dog comes for you, drags you here. No, I don't think so. Even in here, I have more control than you do. I'm not leaving until the one who controls the collars shows. Not his voice, not his hand, not his lackey. Him. And when he comes to see me, we'll settle things. So go on. Go back to your master. Tell him I'm waiting for him. Dog may follow him. I won't. Dog? You're not talking to him now, are you? No. Even if you could drag Dog out of his cage, you still couldn't get him out of this cage. I put him here for a reason. If he could have escaped, he would have. So here he stays. Yes, but Dog doesn't know that. We don't share everything. Sometimes it's a blessing. Sometimes it causes difficulties. Now I think it's a blessing. It keeps you on that side of the cage. Now, you go fetch. Find your master. Bring him here so we can talk. Yes, you could. And once he was out, all starving and hungry, what do you think he would do then? Be careful what cage you open, because he won't go back in it without a fight. He'll tear you apart. He won't care if it kills you both. Obeys, yes. Why? Do you have some means of contacting the old man? You don't play it. If you do, I'll find a way to get out of the cage, end you. I'll murder you, crush your arms and legs until... No, you wouldn't. If you did, you won't escape this place alive. I'd shatter every one of your limbs to splinters and leave you here. You think I'm afraid of your collar exploding, killing us? No. I'll leave you breathing, then keep walking until my collar goes cold. I'll prop your broken body in view of the Sierra Madre so you can see what you came to steal, forever out of reach as you die. No, don't! I'll make you suffer for this, I promise you! Although it may not matter, I suspect the Sierra Madre will be reward enough for ones like you.
Master, the dog not hear you come in. Too hungry now. At cage door. Master, dog is listening. Now you are close, and he can hear you over hunger. Dog doesn't have a... Here it is.
there? How did it get there? Yes, Master. Master sounds different, quieter. Master, Dog doesn't want to be in the cage anymore. Dog will be good this time. Dog promises. Master, Dog waited a long time, brought you many people. If Dog finds more, we'll bring them to the fountain. Dog promises.